Please enjoy your 20s.
I will never take a night bus insult anymore. I'm done.
Hello there. Ooh, I did not have a voice. This is the first time I've spoken today. It is 1 p.m. I need to get moving. That's what I need to do. I'm supposed to go to Bridget's house, right? It's hard. It's hard, y'all. I can't lie to you. I'm struggling right now. But I will make it. I will make it. We will have an afternoon, a good time. We will make it. But, yeah, it's gonna take a while. I don't know if y'all see this. This is called home matte. This is like a mosquito repellent, right? That you turn on. There is like a little thing that you put inside. And I can change every time. This is working perfectly. But my problem with that is it's freaking November. Why am I still fighting for my life every night? I don't get it. I'm tired. I wish you could go away. Anyway, I'm rambling just because I do not want to move. But I'll make it. I'm going. First, I'm watching... Can you see? Kenny JD, the OG. I'm watching her. And once this video is over, I'm gonna go. Okay. It's gonna take about an hour. Should I eat over there? Probably. Anywho, I'm going soon. We are going for a concert today. It is supposed to rain. So I'm gonna take my umbrella. I'm gonna take my stuff. And I'm out of here. Let's go.
Hi, good afternoon. 2:30 p.m. Forgive my voice. Went out last night, and it's actually even more embarrassing than you think because I didn't go out to some club and started yelling until 5 a.m. or anything like that. No, I went to a bar, and we left at maybe like not even 1 a.m. And my body just refuses to recover. It doesn't matter how short of a night we have. We go there, it's 10 p.m. We leave, it's not even, it's like midnight. And we're still completely... So my voice is already like... And it's like flu season, everybody's like getting cold and stuff. So yeah, anywho, we're not really gonna do much today. Leslie's coming over. Just really gonna hang out because we have nothing else to do. We're gonna buy some snacks and we're really just gonna chill. Ooh, I'm so tired. Why? Tell me why. Anybody who's 30 or over, please tell me you're in the same predicament and it's not just me that has a body that's letting me down. And if you're younger than 30, please enjoy your 20s. Please enjoy when you could go to the club and stay until like 5, 6, 7 a.m. I could do this until like maybe a year ago. Until 30, I was good. I could go clubbing. I could go home at like 7 and be cool, whatever. Now, it's not working.
I'm supposed to put all of it inside, yeah. Pretty straightforward.
I don't know, who are you talking to with that British accent?
Myself. What you gonna do about it? Nothing. Mm-hmm. Shut up and let me go.
I don't know, those are not the lyrics.
Ah, bon?
It is the lyrics.
Shut up and let me go. What?
I forgot about that.
You're crazy.
Goddamn. I need to pay my bills. What are you doing? It's not gonna get hot anytime soon.
Can you have a show?
No, it's just gonna be chilled. I told you, just put it in the microwave.
Why are you not hot?
Just out here. Just so pitiful.
Move!
Hey!
Hey!
You actually scared me. I hate to suffer in my own house.
Yeah, it's very disrespectful.
Yeah, well. I'm glad you know. Goddamn. It's so hot for some reason today.
Yeah, it is.
It was cold like not long ago, and now it just forgot about it's the fact that it was fall, and it was like, fuck it.
Yeah, I was fighting. I thought, how long am I supposed to put this for? 3 minutes.
So I put this up last, usually, when I don't have hot water. DIY. That's how it works in this
house. Or just, you know, buy a freaking kettle pot.
I used to have one, you know.
And where is it now?
It takes too much space. What am I going to... Where?
Here?
Literally where? Where?
Down over there?
You? No.
Why not?
I don't like having things on the floor.
No, inside.
Ew, in the cupboard? That's where my cleaning stuff is.
Upside then.
Ew, that's where my...
Shut up! 여기는?
어디? 어, 여기 할 수 있지. Well, this is recent, you know. It's not that recent.
It's not recent at all. I was there.
Yeah.
Stop lying to me. Stop lying to yourself.
With absolutely no looking at you. I'm just lazy. That's the reality.
Yeah, that's... Girl. Okay, this I could get behind. What? She's been trying to finesse her way out of a reasoning.
I tried to finesse my way out of life at this point.
Yeah. Try again.
I'm kind of, you know, zoning it.
Not really.
Trash is in the trash.
I never know which one is
what's for the trash. It makes no sense. Plastic stuff in there. See?
Just plastic.
Oh, plastic. Yay.
That's not just plastic in there, though.
Pinion. And plastic bottles, plastic items.
And paper?
Then I just figure it out. The paper goes in the white one. Don't ask me why, I don't know myself.
Why the fuck? Okay. That's a good sentiment to have.
That was name time. Vicky is right there.
Random, but I was thinking about it on the way here, which is the other side of the world, by the way. Might I add?
Stop this.
It is so freaking far away. I'm so, you know that they're gonna do like a new system because there's too many people in the subway, so that they're just gonna remove. I don't know. I saw 4.7 or something. So I don't know if it's from 4 to 7 line,
yeah.
Or 4 and 7. Anyway, some lines in two cars, in two train cars, they're gonna remove all the seats.
All of them?
All the seats.
So we're just gonna travel like...
That's so dumb because the people are gonna be packed in the other ones.
Ew.
You know what I mean? I'm not gonna choose that car ever. So now we're losing
two cars. What car would you not choose?
The one with no seats.
Why not?
Because do you see the trip I just did? Standing with no chance of sitting.
At least you have the hope.
Anya, at least you have the hope of like, oh, somebody might get out and I might get something.
Yeah.
You have something to look forward to. Telling me in the whole thing I have no seat. Absolutely not.
Yeah, but then everybody's gonna run to the seats place.
That's what I'm saying, so it's even worse.
Then it's better because then you have more space in the, and you can just on the wall like this. And you have less people. I would rather choose the car with less people regardless
of
the
car. Wow, not me, huh? You're crazy. Oh, this looks very bad.
Yeah.
Ew.
But no, yeah, I found that very dumb. I was like, this is not the solution. Maybe like add more transportation options, add more...
Like what?
Something. I don't know, more buses, more traffic, more cars coming.
Like then that's more traffic.
Huh?
Then that's more traffic.
Anyway.
I'm saying the cars, the train. More other option too. Like if it's not a subway, then it's a bus, but an efficient bus.
Yeah.
And stop using your car. Like there's some options. You're just gonna remove the seats with those old people. Everybody's old!
Yeah.
Twara, stop being a pain in my ass, please. Everybody's old and want to sit and fight for their life. It's gonna be like... Mm,
not fight for their lives. Ah! Fighting for their lives
is
true.
My lunch! My very sad looking lunch, but you know what? We hope, we pray it's good. You know what I should have bought? Kimchi. Alright, I'm gonna put sauce all over me. I know!
Please don't.
You know what? It's gonna splatter.
This is the perfect way.
It's not too bad, the hot dog.
Ow! Ow! Shit, I hurt myself.
I hurt myself.
No.
This is not the lyrics. This one I agree.
This is not on the same. See, everything has a place.
Ooh,
I
doesn't
love it.
Smell good.
Yes, it smells like chemicals, but it's good. It's too small. What is this one?
Very bland. How? Mm.
Disappointment.
You're supposed to be awake now. So what's going on?
I told them earlier. I explained. Okay. And you can agree. Because I know you agree. I told them, if you're over 30, please enjoy your time in your 20s. Because you're going to hit 30 and your body is just literally just going to say no. And we went out last night literally, we went there, it was like 10:30 or something, and we got home, it wasn't even 1 a.m., and this is the results. This is not correct.
Let me add to this. I disagree. Because...
You disagree?
I disagree.
Hi.
I don't feel bad right now, at all.
What? I was saying that to them, tell me if it's just me, though. Maybe it is just me.
Today, it is you. I think it's because you're becoming sick. You're
I'm sick. I'm sick.
I'm sick.
But I am sick, though.
That's what I'm saying. I think you're starting to get sick. That's why your body is giving up. But it's not based on what we did yesterday at all, because we didn't do shit yesterday.
No. When I go out now, I leave at like 1 a.m. and I'm screwed.
Man, we didn't do nothing!
In general. No, I can't. So annoying! Why are you like this? I just want to know, why are you like this?
I'm hungry! And it's not satisfying me one bit. Not one bit. I should have taken a salad. The salad is good.
She says she should have taken the salad.
The salad is good.
Oh, vlogception. No, but seriously, like, personally, I don't really survive very well going out. Sometimes I do, for some reason. My body wakes up again. And then sometimes it's just like, well, no, you're going to stay in bed. I woke up today. I didn't have anything. I wasn't like, I didn't feel like my head was hurting. I didn't have a hangover or anything. I was just like, ugh.
How could you have a hangover? We didn't drink.
That's
we
what
didn't
I'm
dance.
I
we
didn't have
drink.
A hangover.
So that's not, like.
But my body's
why are you
just
tired?
Like,
we didn't do nothing except sitting.
I don't know.
In a place with music and talking
know.
A bit and going home.
I need to work out more. That's what.
Yeah.
I think so. I told you I hated that fucking ride. Like that ride home was absolutely awful. I will never take a night bus in Seoul anymore. I'm done. I tried it once, maybe I got unlucky, but it was the worst people in there, annoying as hell, and because it was so busy, people, you know, like, mixing alcohol and just being annoyed is not a good mix, first of all. So people were already kind of belligerent and shit, and like, it was just so, and it stunk so bad, like, it smelled like sweat and everything, and it was just like, ugh! All of us, like, there's a guy next to me, there's two guys next to me, and literally every time we made eye contact, like, I don't know about them, but for me it felt like, yeah. I understand. Because literally I was like this on the thing, like trying to hold on to something.
And not sitting?
Huh?
Not sitting?
Of course not sitting. We couldn't move. It was sardines. Mm. Like when it came, first of all, you could see, of course it had to be my bus that everybody wanted to take. The bus before was already like, people were on the damn window. So it didn't even open the front door because nobody could get on. Opened the back door for people to come out and people just piled onto it. So our bus was the same. Literally everybody, so the next stop even worse because we were already stuck and people decided to still fucking come in, and so the driver started to like be annoyed, like, hey, like, you see it's full, da, 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 just get off. And then the girl in front of me, what pisses me off the most is couples. When there is couples, and I'm not gonna lie, I've been guilty of this too, so I'm not gonna say like, oh, don't do it, because it's normal. Let me explain. When there's couples, there is this thing about like, oh, when it's like crowded, the guy's gonna like protect his girl or whatever, and so I moved because somebody pushed me from behind, so obviously I moved and I touched her and she was like and the guy was like putting his head like trying to, and I was like, bitch, I don't give a fuck about you, like, do you think I really wanted to get closer to you? Don't look at me like I'm a fucking parasite. Like,
so what,
you
did the you too?
No, I did not do the
I mean,
you know they're dramatic as fuck.
I'm saying you
did not
of
do
it.
That but I'm saying I'm guilty of it because one time we were in the this was with one of my old like high school exes. And we were in the subway in Paris. And we weren't even dated at the time. But anyway, we met, like, again a few years later. And we were just talking. And he's really tall and really big and muscular. And so there was a rush in the French subway. And he kind of put... Because he was a bit obnoxious, I'm not gonna lie. So he put... It was a... You don't even know him. You never met him. I can say his name. He doesn't watch these videos. Papi. Mm. His name is Papi. You might have met him like in freshman year or something, like
yeah,
the whole time.
Sure.
Yeah. Mm. Handsome as hell. Anywho, so he put his both hands and he was like, nobody's gonna touch you, nobody's gonna touch you, like, whoa. And I was like, okay, you're embarrassing me right now. But basically, it was that vibe. Like, the guy put his hand, and I was like, in any other circumstances, I would have been like, this is cute, but now you're pissing me the fuck off because I'm not trying to come on to you. I'm just as, like, hard, like, it's hard for me too. Like, what are you talking about? And then another guy, like, when we got, like, pushed around and shit, he decided, I don't know what it is when they see foreigners where they just decide like they have to pretend like they're hip or something, and he's like, oh shit, nigga.
Do you?
But not clearly, not to me, but clearly he knew I was right there. And they didn't know that I spoke Korean, obviously, because his friend was like, yo, shut the fuck up.
Nah, at least, okay.
His friend was like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Shut the fuck up. Like, I thought I heard something, like, right on your left, like, bro, like, someone's there. So, honestly, at first I was like, oh, cool. But then I was like, no, you're just basically protecting your friend, because you know he says that on the daily. You're just like, hey, don't say this in front of them, basically.
Maybe not. Maybe he's actually, like, stuck
it. It's one of the other. Anyway, so I was like, I'm not going to smile at you. I'm not going to act all thankful. No, I'm just going to... I looked at him like... imbecile que vous êtes là. Like, they just feel the need to say things, and I'm like, I'm just sitting here minding my business. Why the fuck do I gotta be in the bathroom now? Like, why do you have to insult me? Why? Let me say the N-word, see what happens. Like, are you dumb? Like,
the
are
N-word you here dumb? Is very weird. They don't see the problem in saying it.
Of course they don't see the problem. Oh, you don't want to have a debate about this? If there are any Americans in the comments, please let us know what you think. And we're not, obviously, like, I'm not trying to, like, start a, like, a violent debate or anything. I'm not American, so I'm not trying to, like, have an opinion when my opinion is not needed, you know what I mean? But what I'm saying is, as a foreigner, like, based on the American point of view, when I was growing up in my country, Senegal, like, everybody was into hip-hop. And everybody looked up to African-Americans because we used to think it was the coolest thing. Like, I personally used to... That was really dumb. But when I was little, I thought America was just black people. Literally, because my older brothers, like my older cousins, they used to like watch BET. And it was all these rap songs. And I was like, oh my god, like when I go to America, I'm going to be like all of them. And like, I just thought everybody was black, literally. So they used to say the N-word all the time. Like my cousin always said it. And I had no idea. So I would like repeat it and like blah, blah, blah. And the thing is, when you go to America, you say it, people don't say anything because you're black too. But I remember a friend of mine who was like, I feel kind of uncomfortable about this because you're not American, like you don't have that history or whatever. And I was like, yeah, but like if I come to America, I show up as a black person. Nobody's gonna be like, she must be African. They don't care, we're treated the same way. So we had a debate on like who is able to say it and who is able to not say it. So personally now, when I go back to friends and stuff, everybody still says it. But like, for example, when my brother says it, I'm like, hey, like, let's like chill. We don't, I'm not saying don't say it, but like, let's try to like, I try to like say it less and like not really say it automatically, because I don't know if there's an American person next to me who's going to be offended. So I try to just stay in my lane, basically. But I feel like it's the same here. Like, they don't know what it means. Most of them, some know very well what the fuck they're doing.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But most of them don't really know. They just hear from the song and they repeat. If you go to the club, who are you gonna fight? Everybody is yelling at the top of their lungs, who are you gonna fight? But I got really pissed off last night because I was like, you saw me get on the bus, like I'm the only black person here. You really just say this on the daily.
Yeah, yeah.
That was like to insult. That was literally to be rude. Annoying, absolutely annoying. But it's weird, like I never know if I can say it or not.
I don't say it as a rule.
I tried to just.
I don't. I just
you know
don't.
What? Let me like sit that one out.
I'm like, nope. I'm not gonna.
I feel like if I'm singing a song at the club, I'm not gonna stop myself because like my other friends are also black and it's like they're Americans too.
Yeah.
So I'm like, we're all together and like we're all black. But like, I'm not gonna be like, oh y'all. Like, yeah, I'm not gonna be like this. I try not to do that.
I don't even know lyrics of songs, so it's not even a problem.
That's
for me.
Yeah.
Hey.
But let us. If there's any American in the comments, I really want to know your perspective on Africans. Or Caribbeans, like anybody, like African descent people that are not American.
And on the other side also, if you're black but not American, how do you feel about saying it? Like, can you in your country, or where you are, is it okay, accepted for you to say it?
But in the other country, people wouldn't care because they probably wouldn't know the history. I mean, they know now.
But is it something that people say even?
I think teenagers say it.
Because of the
feel
media?
Like the songs, yeah. But I feel like as an adult... You can think twice and be like, because you're probably aware of what's going on. But when you're like a child, like a teenager, as teenagers, like for us, it was the coolest. It used to be, you know, like in French, we say, oh, negro.
Mm.
It's the same vibes.
Yeah.
So like, also when we used to be colonized, the French would call us negro.
Mm.
So it's a derogatory term, but for us, it became like a fraternal.
Like a bro.
So it's like, which one is it? Because we have the same version in French.
But we may... Oh. I never realized something. Do white people say negro?
No, they... I mean, if they say it, it's... Okay.
They could
if
know.
They say it, it's actually not a bad word.
That's what I'm saying. It's not as bad as the N-word.
Because it's literally the term for a black person. It's like the same as Caucasian.
Yeah.
But I realize a lot, especially in school or at work, people, like, they have so much, like, white guilt that when they say it, automatically they think, oh, is it racist? It's actually not racist in France, but white people don't really say that. Yeah. But you will see Arab people, hey, negro, they will say it, and it's not a big deal to
us. In between the group of friends, they will say it, but maybe not outside, like, to
especially,
random
people. Urban communities and stuff. Yeah, so it's really interesting. But here, I feel like if I see a Korean say it to me, I'm not going to be mad, like, personally, because I'm like, oh, it's me. But I'm going to be like, you just assume I was American. So that means you say this to America, and you know, or you should know by now, what kind of history there is. So what the fuck?
What I don't understand is, when we tell you something is not correct to be said, why do you say it then? Like, we told you, even if you don't know the whole history, if somebody tells you this is offensive to a certain category of people, why would you go out of your way to say it? Just because.
For what?
What is the random rant? But okay, I finished my rant.
Like, what is the purpose?
Not satisfied, I can't lie to you.
Wow.
It wasn't good.
So, what's the plan now?
I don't know, man. I told them we're just hanging out. Today's the day of hangout. We might watch something, I don't know. What is there to watch anyway?
Thank you for the timing.
But there's nothing much on.
I told them
I do not. Alors, she tagged me in a post in the trailer of, what's his name? Park Seo-joon.
I want to see it.
I don't want to see that movie.
I just want to see him.
I want to see him. I don't want to see that movie.
So let's go see him.
With the whole movie around it?
Okay, who cares?
It looks boring as hell.
Come on. I didn't watch the trailer. Wait. Let me watch the trailer then. Because I actually don't know. I just saw somebody made a cut of him and I was like,
yeah, that looks cool. The cut looks good.
I had not.
But the trailer looks boring as hell.
I don't even know what it is about.
Also, Marvel is disappointing me left and right lately.
Well, Marvel has disappointed. Okay, let me see. Cause I don't even know. I just saw. I don't know what it is about. I mean, it looks like more of a comedy.
Yeah, but not really entertaining or anything like that.
Where is Park Seo Joon?
There he is.
He got like what, 1.1 second?
Yeah.
Oh.
And then, are you willing to sit through like maybe 2 hours of this just for 5 minutes of Park Seo Joon?
I would have to be extremely bored. Yeah. But okay.
Yeah, that's my point. Okay. Too bad, because it looks really cool. Marvels, I'm gonna sit that one out, I think. For the time being, at least.
I did not realize it would be like that.
Yeah.
I mean, I would go see it. Like, one day when I have nothing to do.
And if it's like cinema day, and it's half the price, because I'm not.
Wow.
I'm not about to pay full price for this. I'm not. I'm really not. I'm sorry.
Wow.
I'm sorry.
When is cinema day?
The last Wednesday of the month.
Of each month?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
But the last Wednesday of that month, I'm gonna watch Napoleon.
For what?
It's the big blockbuster of the town at the moment. It's
really?
Yeah. It's like a big name with a big name actor as well. It's the Joker guy.
Ah, yeah. I remember seeing that.
Ridley Scott director. It's gonna be a big movie, I think.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna watch that one on movie day, and I'm gonna wait for Marvel. Yeah. I don't really care for Marvel that much anymore. Kills me to say that. Yeah. Kills me. But it is what it is.
No. Just be where I'm at. You don't really need.
It's I mean. Lot.
Finally, thank you very much. It was not ideal, I'm not gonna lie.
Why do we yell this for yelling?
For no reason.
This didn't achieve nothing.
Panicking for no reason! Yay!
Now it's a bed! Ta-da! We have a bed!
Can't even see me. I'm just
hey.
A shadow in the corner.
Yeah, you look very bleak
over there. As I should.
Ching. Doing this. Too big. Ay.
Everything
else is fine. You think that the
I don't mind everything else. But
the torso?
Yeah, I don't mind. I'm not saying I like. I said I don't mind. The thighs are where I draw the line.
Yeah. Too much.
Hours later.
Literally, we haven't moved from that bed.
I slept.
It's actually embarrassing.
What did you do? Did you work?
I did
she this. Worked on her computer.
I just cut already this section. Nothing much to cut. We're just rumbling out there.
It's quite late.
It's late. Too late. I'm hungry. I'm gonna go home. My subway is waiting for me at my door.
Bye, yums. We'll see you in the next vlog.
Bye.
When we're a bit more presentable.
Yeah.
and doing something because we did nothing today.
Yeah, like, please bear with us.
It was the rain. It's a rainy day. When it's a rainy day, you're just lazy. Yeah, it happens.
It is
to
what
the
it
best
is.
Of us.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go home.
Say goodbye to Leslie.
Bye.